Seterusnya, usaha-usaha keagamaan oleh berbilang bangsa dan agama di seluruh negara tidak mengenal lapisan usia, malah ia turut melibatkan golongan kanak-kanak.
Di Brainy Bunch International Islamic Montessori, One City Subang Jaya, anak-anak kecil di sini tidak ketinggalan memanjatkan doa dan melakukan solat hajat bagi keselamatan penumpang MH370.
We have 56 campuses nationwide, daripada Kedah sampai ke Kota Kinabalu. Dan hari Isnin itu kita minta semua campus untuk lakukan solat hajat with our children, mostly our preschool, preschoolers. And then we hope that anak-anak kita ni, dia budak-budak kan, dia tak ada, dia bersih lagi, dia very pure. And we hope that Allah SWT will listen to dia doa.
Berita kehilangan MH370 menjadi perbualan hangat bagi kanak-kanak kecil ini di tadika Brainy Bunch ini.
When I woke up at 6:30 and I turned on the TV because I can't sleep. Okay. And then I saw the news. I was like so shocked. Eventually the answer is from Allah. Eventually I don't really know, but then inshallah they will find the airplane. But then I feel like I have heard some rumors, but then my mom said don't believe in them. They're just trying to make something.
So many places send so many ships, jets. Little bit sad. I wish that Allah will help us to find all the passenger, the pilot.
The plane is like, it's like somebody, like there's two people, the passport they stole. I think it's like hijacking, but I don't know yet. So I hope the families all have a strong heart.
I know about it that it lost in 49 minutes. That one parent from Brainy Bunch is in the airplane. They said one of them said in Vietnam, China. One of them said they already arrived in Antarctica like that. So I don't believe that. I feel like for I'm sad, but for the children, I think they are really sad. So I hope that they are safe.
Tadika ini juga menyimpan cerita yang pilu kerana salah seorang murid Brainy Bunch sedang menanti kepulangan ibunya dan seorang lagi anak kecil di sini merindui neneknya yang merupakan antara penumpang MH370.
Also one of our parents and the grand mother pun one of the passenger in the plane. So I think we are, you know, doing what we can. I think it's on that.
Kebanyakan kanak-kanak ini pernah dan selalu menaiki kapal terbang. Sebelum ini, mereka seronok menaiki kapal terbang dan setelah kejadian MH370 ini, pandangan mereka berubah.
Sometimes I'm a bit like scared because I feel like I will become like the MH370 and I'll be like really scared.
I always afraid that when my mother go to Beijing, I always want to follow, but when my mother already go to Beijing, in my heart I say that I always do out for my parents to come back.